just going back to childhood memories, seeing my grandmother, my moms, my aunt cooking at the house, cooking for events, traditional ceremonies. I think that's where my love for food really started. Just looking at them, respecting the ingredient, and just everything they do, there is steps to everything, and then you get the final product that is going to taste amazing. When my mother asked me to cook for her, I don't even cook for her because I'm scared, because her skills compared to my skills, I'm a baby to that. Communication is very, very, very important, more especially actually the whole team, not just the chefs, because everyone is specializing in something in the kitchen. For one plate, basically, just making an example, not one person makes the whole plate. Every component is coming from somewhere. Someone else is going to be giving you salad leaf. Someone else is going to be giving you a dressing. Someone else is going to be giving you the protein. So the teamwork is very important there. And then also when it comes to front of house, they need to be knowledgeable about the menu, the food. So that communication is very important. And time, timing is very important in our industry. We specialize in making crepes, running breakfast the whole day. It is a small cafe, so we're giving people that experience of having their favorite breakfast meal the whole day round. And then we make awesome pancakes also. But my favorite dish here, it's a Mexican salad. It's fresh, there's nothing cooked there. You got your sweet corn, you got your black beans that are marinated in Mexican dressing that we make here in-house. So that dish for me, it just stands out all the time.
If you've just joined us, then you're just in time for the second part of our cook-along. Chef Apelele, you were once in studio with us and we made cauliflower, right? And we're making cauliflower again today.
But this cauliflower now, we're doing it in a different style also. I mean, like cauliflower, it is my favorite vegetables, as you can get it anytime. It is cheap, anyone can afford it.
Okay, so what are we making today?
So right now we're making yeasted cauliflower with pickled grapes and then some fresh mint vinaigrette on it.
All right, lead us, my leader.
Lead us, okay. What you'll be doing there for us, you're going to be chopping the cauliflower. You just need it to resemble like breadcrumbs, but small pieces. And then Chef D, that side, is going to be cutting florets for us and doing some shavings with the cauliflower. And then here, I'll be making the roasted grapes. We're roasting our grapes before we pickle them because we want to release the juices in. So, and then when we pickle and introduce the acid to the vinegar, and then it absorbs quickly that way.
Okay. You were mentioning off camera that it is always best to pickle an ingredient when it's warm.
Yeah,
that absorbs.
That helps it to absorb the flavor. Because pickling something that's cold or raw, most cases, the flavor just sticks on the outside, and then it's not really going into whatever you wanted to pickle.
Okay, interesting. Right, you said you want it to resemble breadcrumbs, so it basically means elbow grease for me, right? Just chop, chop, chop.
Chop, 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 chop.
Okay, perfect.
So what I'm doing here, I added honey, a teaspoon of brown sugar, and then 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar. And then these, you're just gonna mix them together. This will go on a tray and then we'll bake this off. Also for about 10 minutes up until they start popping.
Until they start popping?
Yeah, popping, releasing the juice or breaking up.
Okay.
I'm taking this to the oven now.
All right, and Chef Dion, I see you're also busy over there.
I'm just cleaning the cauliflower out. So what I've done is, I don't know if it's part of Apelele's dish, but it can be an additive because it's adding some raw. So the stems, I kind of slice them really, really fine and then shock them in ice water. It's a great addition to salads. It's got like this raw cauliflower juice flavor in it. And then the leaves are absolutely unbelievably tasty. It's like a cauliflower cos lettuce. Are phenomenal.
I was actually going to ask you that right now because I'm making the cauliflower. Do you remove the bark or the stem of it when you...
I honestly waste nothing. So the heart of the cauliflower I used to pickle. I use them in purees, fermented pickles that take a longer time where there's no heat added to it. To be honest, I rarely use the florets nowadays because there's so much more applications with the rest of the cauliflower.
Yeah, I mean, like, I use the stock also. If you shave it up into thin pieces and then deep fry that, that makes beautiful chips. But you need to be careful because that section of the cauliflower contains a lot of sugar in it and then they'll brown up quickly. Just in half, please, Chef D.
Now, Chef, we're talking about private chefing here. That's the theme of today's show. Has there been one dish that whenever you have a gig or something like that, that people always go to, you know, that they always ask you to make, you know, like, I want you to make beef stew or I want you to make cauliflower. What's the one dish that people always ask for?
It depends on the client mostly, like what they want, but you tend to have favorites that people go for. Mamorican lamb curry, they love that with some pickled red onions. That is always a winner. And then also I always go back to my baby, the cauliflower with grilled aubergine. And then you have some sweet potato chips on it. People go crazy all for that. I'm quickly going to check on the grapes now. Hear them sizzling.
And Chef Dion, for you, is there that one dish that people always fall back on?
To be honest, not even bragging, my scope is huge. There's nothing I cannot make. But I specialize in Indian cuisine, and I found that there's not a big market for it in the Cape Town area. Mm. So there's been a big demand for Indian cuisine because it's sort of like that specialized type of cuisine that you don't really find anywhere else. So, I mean, I've cooked for some guys in the middle of the bush, and it's kind of the food that works with the surroundings. But I found Indian cuisine's been the number one sort of request.
Wow, interesting. Both of you basically have experience in working in restaurants and working as private chefs. What's the major difference, you'd say, both industries? He laughs.
Jeez, it's huge. I mean, I was leading a team of 14. I mean, in a holistic point of view, there was about 50 chefs in the entire kitchen. Now I'm dealing with myself. So, I mean, I'd send myself voice notes in the evening. Yo, dear, I hope you have an amazing private function tomorrow. And don't forget to buy the dal because you forgot to purchase cream. And then make sure you set the yogurt before you leave because if you forget that, it's going to be a big mess up. And then lastly, just have fun tomorrow. And the next day, I listen to my voice note. It's a handover I gave myself. So, I mean, it's a completely different world. The stress levels have dropped. I mean, you can listen to my voice.
I can hear
so you. So calm and cool and collective. So, yeah, it's an entire different game baller.
All right, and I see it's got a bit of charred bits on there. Is that what you want? Or?
That's the color we're looking for because that helps it also to release the nutty flavor from the cauliflower. Because cauliflower tend to be bland if you just blanch it. So this introduced another flavor element to this also.
And I mean, Chef, you're charring over there, right?
Yeah, so I'm char grilling the cauliflower. We've just cut them in half. And a good tip to charring vegetables is get your pan absolutely hot, a very high heat. Always use all your senses, feel it literally. And it's just to that point where it scorches. And then you want your pan to be dry. So you want to actually put your vegetable into a dry pan without any fat in at that point. Because here's where you're going to get that really nice charred carbon grilled at the base of it. And then once you get your vegetable to completely stick at the bottom, then you add a little bit of oil just underneath the space where it's cooking. And you can see the smoke now coming from the top.
Okay, now the cauliflower is caramelized. We're going to add butter to it.
Okay.
So the butter, you're going to let it cook up until it starts bubbling. That's where you get the beautiful biscuity flavor from the burnt butter that you're making. So you don't want to be stirring it all the time. So once that has melted in there, we're going to introduce now the yeast.
I was going to ask, where does the yeast come in?
So now we're going to introduce the yeast to the cauliflower.
And what is the purpose of the yeast in this instance?
So it's quite a bit of butter as well.
Yeah. So the yeast, what it does here, it gives you the malty flavors. It just elevates that cauliflower and then you get the richness from it. So it's like you're having malted beer.
So it's not really getting activated.
No, because I'm cooking it now in the heat, so that will kill the yeast. But now you're just getting the flavor. If you'd smell this, you're getting the cauliflower smell. I mean the yeast flavor now. See?
Oh, jeez, wow.
Even your glasses.
No, but the smell, it's almost got that Bernoisette flavor in there with this hint of this bread yeasty taste. And then you got that charred cauliflower that comes through. Very nice.
So that's what you're looking for there. So once that's cooked out, so you give it about 2 minutes for the cauliflower, for the yeast to cook out, because you don't want your puree to be bubbling up. So from there, we're going to be adding milk.
We don't want anyone getting drunk on cauliflower.
No. So that will take about 5 minutes to cook, just for the flavors to incorporate together, and then we'll blend that for 7 minutes to get it smooth. So while here, the grapes have come out of the oven. So now, look at this, all this juice. This juice was in there before.
Yeah.
So the juice is coming out of the grapes and then you're getting the acid from the apple cider vinegar and then the honey just binds it together. So here we're going to do 2 tablespoons of honey, of apple cider vinegar again. Because the grapes tend to be quite sweet if you roast them off because now the sugars are caramelizing.
Yes. Just the question is, do you need to use a specific type of yeast? Must it be dry yeast? Do you have to use fresh yeast for it?
Both work, but you just need to be careful when you're using dry yeast because dry yeast is tends to be more potent than the fresh one sometimes. Okay. So yeah. So the olive oil, a little bit of salt. So that's softening up, so this goes here.
It actually looks very caramelly with the brown butter now. It's become beurre noisette and the charring of the cauliflower. This is quite a labor-intensive recipe, Chef. I mean, I'm imagining you having to do 50 of these.
I mean, like making one batch of puree, it will last you a while because you can use it for a lot of things also instead of using it for this cauliflower. So I'm gonna add acid to it also. That breaks the richness from the butter and the cauliflower.
So at the end, you need to play around with the salt, the acidity ratio to get that consistency and flavor right.
That's quite interesting, Chef, because most people would assume that that's perfect as is, but I guess it's also playing with the palate because the tongue has the different senses here, sweet, sour, so that's where you basically touch them.
This is perfect now.
Okay.
You taste that, Chef Dean?
Yeah, sure.
I'm sure you're always expecting an A plus.
Yeah. Yep. Oh my word, it's complete. I've never tasted something like it before.
So that takes that whole cauliflower. It's
like a cauliflower beer.
And also tastes very creamy, like very cheesy. You'd swear that there's some cheese in there, but there's...
It's brought this sort of... It's almost like I'm eating peanut butter.
I know, right?
It's nice.
Right now I'm just infusing olive oil with some mint, fresh mint then.
And I see all the textures we're talking about now. You've got that nice creamy puree in the center. You've got the crunchiness of the cauliflower that you charred, which is going to bring in that smoky flavor. And then you've got the sweet and caramelly flavor, or sweet and sugary flavor of the grapes with that acidic.
And that vibey, pickly grapes that just cuts through and cleans everything out.
And then that fresh cauliflower to end the crunch at the end. So yeah.
Okay, guys. I'm getting ready to dig in, but there's still more, guys. We did say that we've got two different types of themes. We've got the Mediterranean Chef Apelele, and then we're going a little bit Indian now, right?
Yeah, we're going full on Indian now.
Not a little bit of Indian.
Then we've got an Indian theme coming up, so do join us after these.